Now, just looking briefly at the readings this morning, they're quite interesting. And we get a glimpse into the early church and all the travels that Paul did. And we're told he went to a place called Lystra. And there he met a man named Timothy. Timothy, his mother was a believer, was a Jewish believer. But we're told his father was a Greek. So it must have been a mixed marriage in that sense. But then Paul wanted Timothy to join him. But for Timothy to join Paul, it was a painful experience because the poor guy had to be circumcised in order not to offend the Jews. Now, subsequent to that, Timothy became a very, very important person with Paul, and he was a partner with Paul, for example, in writing the letter to the Romans. And also, if you remember, it's a reading from Paul's letter to Timothy. He's one of his final letters, actually, where we read Paul wrote to Timothy, "I'm already being poured out as a libation, and the time of my departure has come." So there was a great, you know, very, very close companionship between Paul and Timothy, and he was a great partner with Paul in establishing the early church and reaching out to the non-Jews and to the Gentiles. And then for a moment, you know, when you read the gospel, you've got to put it into where are we today in relation to what we've just been reading in the gospel this morning. And the gospel is always in the now, very much in the now. And Jesus is forewarning his followers, you know, you're going to be disliked. If you're going to be a true follower of mine, you're not going to be liked. In fact, you're going to be persecuted. You're going to be hounded. Now, just for a moment, as we are here this morning, look at all the followers of Christ throughout the world that are being persecuted, losing their lives. Why? Because they're of Christianophobia, because of hatred of Christians. And we see that. Now, you may not be aware of that where you live or in this country, but it is very, it's still a fact. It's still very, very much there. There are many people out there who would, and even in our own church, who kind of would look at you and say, "Well, why do you need to go to Mass every day?" And if you were in Ireland at the moment, they really would be looking at you. And there's a tremendous, while you're not locked up, and while you're not in prison, and your life is not at risk, still there's a lot of muted hatred out there for Christians. A lot of, very, very much. When I go back to Ireland, it's very tangible. You can feel it. The animosity. I was talking to Monsignor last night about this. The animosity towards the church in Ireland, very much in the media. And among family, you know, they look at you. Many members of my own family no longer go to church. If you ask them why, well, you know, because this, that, and the other thing. And of course, they have been given many ready-made excuses, like, going back, it was child abuse. Now it's the pandemic. And to many followers of Jesus, thank God for the pandemic. We now don't really have to show up at church. And so we may not be locked up, as I said, but it's very much there. And so for us, who hopefully are true followers of Jesus, we need to stand up and be counted. And it's not a question of fighting or arguing, but look at ourselves. And do we give the impression that it's good to be a follower of Jesus, that it brings about a change in our lives, where people who you can trust, where people who are sincere, if we say we'll do something, we'll carry it out. Where people who are truthful, where people who have a word, where people who are joyful. We've a smile on our face. We're happy. We're not angry, as a lot of people are, even in the church. We're happy. We're happy people. We're not always fighting for our own little corner. We're not always on the defensive. We're just nice, happy people. And we give the impression, yeah, I'm a joyful person. I'm grateful for what I have. We have a gratitude about us. That's what we need to be today. We don't need to preach. It's by our lives that we impress people. No need for words. Just be loving, caring, joyful, happy, contented people.